Howdy everybody, Colorado Biker here, and I am about to go into the Ark Encounter. Yes, I'm in Williamstown, Kentucky, and strangely enough, it's raining and we're under a severe weather watch right now, possibly a tornado watch later. So is this a sign from above? So we're about to go in and hopefully the rain will let up a little bit and I'll be able to do a few pictures outside before I go into this. So anyway, enjoy the video and we'll see what we have to come. Another one ride the bus. Another one ride the bus. And another comes on and another comes on. Another one ride the bus. And as you can see, it's a shitty day out. It's actually really windy and nasty and pretty crappy. So we'll go inside and see what we can see. The empty lines. See, do I have my wristband? Yeah, it's pink. I'm wondering about that. Okay, they have sound effects going. Thunder and lightning sound effects, and it's thundering and lightning outside. Can't tell which is the real thing. Delivery wagon. Okay. And of course the mobility scooters. I didn't know that they had those back then. You know, you could turn the fake thunder sound effects off. It's probably going to start doing that outside here in any minute. The great deep shall birth forth. Shall burst forth. Ah, the firmament. These are interesting. I guess that would be for water. Yeah. And this would probably be for food. Oh, and there's fake noises coming out of them. They really think this is what happened. It's amazing. Noah. Oop, they got flashes of light. Lots of lightning. Ooh, lots of lightning. Okay. More cages. More amphora. Wow, this place is big on the inside. 99% of all species gone extinct. Noah did bring many animals that are now extinct. Let's see what we have here. Okay, transitional species number one. I have a feeling we're going to see a lot of that. And of course, a 200 plus million year old species. And of course, dinosaurs. There we go. Did you know up to 85 kinds of dinosaurs were on the Ark, including two Tyrannosaurids, Stegosaurids, Ceratopsids, Brachiosaurusids, smaller than bison. How do we determine the number of animal kinds? Seven flying creatures and clean animal. The pre-flood biblical stuff. We have day one, the Genesis account. All through there. We'll give them credit, the artwork is really good. They hired some very good artists. Look at that. Tells you all about the expulsion. Cain murders Abel. They were bringing something to the board that. Fall of man, the descent into darkness, metalworking, music, polygamy, civilization, giants, and violence. Nothing new there. Artistic interpretation, that says a lot right there. That definitely says a lot. Because, well, they do an artistic interpretation of everything. But it's good art. It's very good art. Hey, that looks a bit like the Maya, or Aztec, Toltec, Olmec. Yeah, Maybe they're getting a little confused. Ooh, we're slaughtering dinosaurs now. Look at that, see? Triceratops, or Stegosaurus, I'm not sure what it is. But yeah, they're slaughtering dinosaurs, okay?
Let's see here. Living for pleasure. Hedonism. Yes, is my favorite. I love it. Oh, yes. Look at this. Oh, they got some nice dioramas here, too. Look at this thing. Woo. Oh, man. Some of these chicks are hot. Okay. Oop, oop. Get a bit of side boob. And then the devastation of war. It's always been devastating. That's the whole fucking point. Divine judgment. Ah, this is where we come into. Yes. All right. And then there it is. There's the Ark and everybody clamoring to get on board and dying. And ooh, somebody being eaten by a shark. Look at that. Yep. Huh, that's a kid's level, too. I wonder. And of course, we're back to the kind bullshit. The Pachycetid. What? Pachycetus. They have Pachycetus, a transitional species. What's wrong with this picture? The Cynogathinid kind, another transitional species. Hyena kind, the alligator kind. Okay, caiman, yes. Ooh, little ones too, little tiny ones. And they're eating grain for some reason. I don't know why, they're carnivores, but yet they're eating grain. And they got one massive water jug. And this place is huge. I mean, look at this shit. This kind of architecture? Yeah. Noah did this? I don't think so. And I see steel bolts and steel reinforcements everywhere. So, yeah, I think they're a little bit full of shit. So, it's pretty, though. I gotta give them credit. It is pretty. But it is completely fucking wrong. So, all transitional species. Every single one. This is how you indoctrinate young children. This is kids' spooky animal encounters. What do animals do when Noah's family is sleeping? They eat them. You got a monkey? You know all kids love monkeys. It's a monkey, 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 monkey. Okay. So yes, let's indoctrinate the little kids. Rhinoceros kind. Trigonius. Another transitional species. Gee! Were unicorns on the Ark? Mesohippus. Another transitional species. This is a bit crazy now. Every single thing that I see in here is a transitional species for evolution, not for creationism. They're actually making a case against themselves. This is mind-boggling. People actually believe this shit. These are anti-evolution people, but yet they're using every species of transitional. It's just amazing. Okay, here we go. More dinosaurs. Ooh, look at a mean dinosaur. Got to get the kids in on this, you know. You gonna get somebody? Yeah, she's hot. She's really hot. Look at those spikes on her back, man. Ooh, that is hot. Okay, I guess that's the punk in me. Chiropsis. The hippo kind. And why are they out of water? They spend most of their time in water. Stegosaur. Ooh, stegosaurs. I love these when I was a kid. And once again, complete bullshit. Wow. Canids, of course. And look at that. There's the evolutionary tree. But they're creationists. Wait a minute. Phyllis. Look at that. Another evolutionary species. The only problem with that is it would be hyper-evolution. And it was only, you know, 5,000-6,000 years ago. To get all the species that we'd have today, there would have to be something like 40 species emerging every day for 5,000 years. So, this is ridiculous. Species give rise to new species. Modified characteristics develop over time. Yeah, so there would have to be something like 40 species a day just popping into existence. Archaeopteryx. See, look, they have question marks. They have question marks. At least they have feathers on it. So that's accurate. Pongonids! Yes, the apes, of which we are one of them. We are a Pongonid. Yep, we share a common ancestor. And all the kids' favorites from Jurassic Park, the Tyrannosaur. Yes. What did the Ark's carnivores eat? Preserved meat. There's There's our Tyrannosaurus. And they're eat, once again, look at this. They're eating grain. How the hell would they chew it? Their teeth are not designed for that. Their teeth are designed for meat, for ripping and tearing and slicing, not for grinding. They have completely the wrong type of teeth, so they would have to swallow it whole. Which, well, you know, you're gonna have a lot of farty dinosaurs in. The Azadon, look at that. Wow. They really are stretching it, man. This is really, wow. Once again, transitional species. There's the Fusarius. Oh, and look, someone's gonna lose their fucking hand. She's trying to feed it. Yep, she's gonna lose her hand. And where did she get the fresh root vegetable from? That's a bit suspicious. Okay, animal care. This is where we get into the logistics. Let's see, 850 per person per day. Reptiles, amphibians. How can they deliver drinking water, remove animal waste, sustain fresh air, provide sufficient light? Now my question would be, with the waste, what about all the hydrogen sulfide, methane, carbon dioxide, and carbon monoxide gas that's generated by decomposing animal matter, as well as curing and decomposing wood from the actual boat itself? This would make it entirely impossible to breathe within this space if it truly had only one large window, as it says in the book. So it's completely, it doesn't make any sense whatsoever from a logistical standpoint. Nigersaurus, that's a cool looking one too. They did a good job with that. They did good job on the models. I'll give them credit there. They did good job on the models. Lighting, artificial lighting, opening concept, covering concept, clean water, a rain catchment, cistern, so basic interlinked cistern system. So liquid waste removal. You gotta take a pee. And it's some giant column thing here in the back. Okay, here comes some dude. Oh, the pee pipes. Ah. Okay, what about the urea? Yeah, there have to be the urea and the ammonia levels would be through the roof. The solid waste removal. Gotta do the poo. Alright, so wheelbarrows full of poo. Go down. Oh, you're gonna be a shit shoveler. Wouldn't you like to have that job? And there's a an elephant, pachyderm of some sort. And it pulls it up to the top and dumps it out. Why not just dump it over the side of the damn boat? Why did they have to get so complicated? You just dump it over the side of the boat. This is convoluted and very, very stupid. Ventilation. Now this would be the one. Wave powered purifier. Okay, this I gotta see. Air come in, air go out. Ah, I see. They're using hydraulics with some form of venting system. Okay, wave powered purifier. Alright, this is incredibly stupid. Wow. I feel dumber for actually considered their concepts. This is, wow, I really don't get it. We have the animatronic Noah answering questions. So we're gonna go ask a question. So you got a touch screen. Ooh, they had touch screens on the Ark.
How many animals are on the Ark? That's a good question. There are about 1,400 kinds of animals on the Ark. And this works out to be fewer than 7,000 animals. I don't remember the exact numbers. I put my son Shem in charge of keeping track of those details. Any more questions? Well, back to my writing.
Oh, we have the library, the record keeping. Look at this. What a load of shit. Whole bunch of paper. Oh, we have the wood shop. Yeah, the workshop for doing all the work on the boat. Try and keep it afloat for a friggin' year. which has never been done since and is almost technically impossible. Oh, and look, somebody's carving a little birdie. I don't think they would have time for doing artistic renditions of whatever in wood and whatever materials would be extremely valuable on the boat. And this is what I don't get. You're on a giant piece of wood floating in the water, but yet you are going to have a forge, something hot enough to burn down the whole friggin' boat with metalworking. They got their metalworking blacksmith, the smithy. Here we go. Who was Noah? And just kind of goes around, tells you, you know, who he was as a young man, and then getting his skills and being 800 years old and building a giant boat. And now we're going to go on to the second part of indoctrinating children, which is over here, Fairy Tale Ark. Let's go see the Fairy Tale Ark. Look at this. Ooh, that's well done. It looks almost like Disney production or something. Look at that. Looks like Dumbo. That really does look like Dumbo, doesn't it? I can convince you the flood was not real, then I can convince you that heaven and hell are not real. Oh, I like that. I gotta get a picture of that. And look, there's an evil lizard snake thing. I don't know. It's not really any kind of snake. Maybe a dragon? All the books. Ooh, all the old books of Noah's Ark. This is cute. The deceptions. 7 D's of deception. Disregarding God's word, distorting the message, deceptively cruel, discrediting the truth, destructive for all ages, disorienting the reader, defaming God's character. Okay, like a kid could read any of that. Oh, and I got that cute Disney music. And everyone died except the 8 people on the ark, or in the ark. Yep. And that means that we're all a bunch of inbreds. Yep, that means we're all related. Everybody's your cousin. Wow, we would have really had to been having sex like mad after this. This is crazy. This is crazy beyond crazy. That's just, this is disturbing. Help me understand. This is where they try to explain why the God of the Old Testament is such an asshole. Evil, vindictive, cruel, vicious asshole. The door. I am the door. Whoever enters through me will be saved. Well, it's fucking closed. I love their ventilation system. Noah was one hell of an architect, way ahead of his time. One door to be saved. Yes, you must be saved from the watery judgment. Is GenesisHistory.com? I would say absolutely not. It is not. It's a fairy tale. Oh, they got some goats. They got... Ooh, we're going to go play with the goats. We're going to go play with goats. All right. This is... I think this is the entirety of their petting zoo. Look, it's the goats.
Hi. Who are you? Hello. You pygmies. Hello.
Yeah, we have animals up here every day.
Oh, do you?
And every day they change. Like, we'll have the goats up here today.
Okay.
Or we might have our miniature donkeys.
Oh, okay, good, right. So they got goats. They have animals up here all the time, every day, he says. And it is oddly vacant. They could have packed a lot more stuff in here. Maybe they ran out of money. Ooh, why the Bible is true? Because the Bible says it's true. Yes, it's circular reasoning. Never mind about logic. The Bible is God's word. Fully inspired, authoritative, and without error. Unique and unified. 40 different writers, 1,500 years. Okay, faithfully passed down. No, it hasn't. Fulfilled prophecy. No, it hasn't. What was the key to eternal life? That's a new one. Okay, well, we knew the bullshit was getting deep, but just didn't know how deep. Wow, look at all the room in here. Okay, the living quarters. What a luxury. Noah's family. Why are the living quarters so nice? Well, they're going to spend a year there. And once again, it comes down to artistic license. All right. Damn, that's nicer than my house. Shit. Oh, look, they got time to do pretty pottery. Got all sorts of stuff here. Plants would die with no light. Fresh fruits, vegetables, garlic. Looks like little mini cabbages. Onions, parsnips, I guess.
or some species of carrot, herbs. See, up the kitchen. All right, my favorite spot. Giant amphora jars. Oh, look at all the fresh bread. Yeah, right. Purple carrots. We've got some lettuce, grapes. There we go, some squash. Now that would last long. Artichokes would be gone really quick. Onions, more white carrots or parsnips. Basic implements of stuff like that. Some simple cooking pots and fire pots, which is what they did. And baking. I like how they have this. Okay, so this is an attempt to explain how they were able to grow plants with no light inside of a sloshing boat with not enough fresh water. They had plenty of manure, but no fresh water. This I find highly questionable. A loom for doing fabrics, but I really seriously doubt they would have time. Eating and meeting. Looks like this is where they have some of the birds in their living quarters. Never mind that they would stink like fuck. Couple of raptors there. And can we look up his tunic? No, we can't. Darn it. How about hers? I want to look up her tunic. She's cute. We're gone, so let's go into the Hall of Bullshit. The flood. What happened outside the Ark? Okay, let's see what other forms of bullshit they have going. Ooh, the Ice Age.
The amazing story, The Lost Squadron, shows us that these are not annual rings. Once again, we see that observable, testable, and repeatable science contradicts the secular belief in millions of years and confirms the truth recorded in scripture.
Babel. Got a cute little one. Oh, the Tower of Babel. Cool. Wow, that's a cool little diorama, too. Biblical model of language. Evolutionary model of language, which is more accurate. Superficial biological differences. Wait a minute. They're using genetics. Well, no, you're using chromosomal pairs. Aliens and the pyramids. Okay, this is ridiculous. Used to promote racism. No, but it was used to promote slavery. Yes. You know, you can beat your slave as long as he doesn't die, you're okay. Ancient man, ooh, let's see what they have to say. Brilliant or brute? I'm a brute. Oh, come on. I feel sad. They have Isaac Newton up here in the one place that is the most unscientific, although he was a theist. Pre-flood potential, how could anyone build something so large and sophisticated? Well, we have castles. We have pyramids, so... But yet anyone is still yet to build a boat as big as this one was supposed to be. And actually have it seaworthy. What else do we have here about ape ancestry? Oh, this is good. A flat earth. At least they deny a flat earth. We'll give them credit. Evolution of religion is true. Ape ancestry is true. Not ape. Well, common descent. Flooded with legends. Let's see. Flood legends. Yes. But only a few of them. And floods are common everywhere. Hey, they already have Gilgamesh. Look at this. They have Gilgamesh. And Akkadian. Yep, but they all differ very, very greatly. Capital punishment. So God's in favor of killing. Hey, there's no surprise there. Hey, Voyage of the Book. Personal stories of taking a Bible around the world. Ooh, a Torah. That's a Torah. Nice, that's a nice Torah too.
Hey, it's the Jews, you know. Yeah, right. I paid too much damn money to come into the place. It's too damn expensive.
Sending the Bible around the world. course, these are all replicas. They wouldn't have anything actual real here. It would go against everything. Well, it'd be, it's not an actual museum, I guess you would say. It's just a house of propaganda. And I'm sure most of them are replicas. They're too valuable. Note, they haven't taken it to Persia or Syria or the Assyrian empires or anywhere like that because, well, they would have been beheaded because it would have been against Allah. And this is the Searching for the Truth exhibit. Looks like a Jack Chick track. It really does. Looks like a Chick track. Look at that. This is the propaganda arm. I think that is it because the top level is not open yet. That's it for now from the propaganda capital.
We've had a walk around the Ark Encounter. So this has been an enlightening experience, to say the least. So I would have to say that they've done a very professional job. It looks really good. The sound effects are everywhere. I think that's a big part of it, so it's not just some dry, plain museum. It was $42 to get in, and then I had to pay $10 on top of parking. So for $52, no, I'd rather go get a cheap hooker. This is not a place I would like to, no. This is not good. I mean, it's entertaining, and that's the way I look at it. It's entertainment today. However, there are some very troubling things that I noticed throughout the entire thing. It is just retarded on some levels. I mean, I can't understand how some people can actually believe some of this shit. And especially a lot of the propaganda type stuff that they put out there, calling it creation science. I think that's my biggest problem, is that they're trying to conflate the two, you know, science and theology and religion, and it's not either. Yeah, this is basically just a small group's take on the history and genesis of our planet, mankind, civilization, and everything else. And it is so rife with errors and problems that I really don't see how anyone with any kind of reasonable education could believe this without having first been incredibly indoctrinated into this, you know, way of thought. It's actually kind of frightening. We're getting down to the bottom, so I'm going to have to exit through the gift shop, of course. We'll do a quick walkthrough on the gift shop. So, just like any tourist attraction, you got to walk through the gift shop. Exit through the gift shop. Ooh, snack bar. Gotta have a snack bar. Ice cream, too. Ooh, big gift shop. Love their reference section. Well, for spending $50, I can't afford shit in their gift shop anyway. Ooh, it's a steel ostrich. Okay, just like anywhere, exit through the gift shop. They got all sorts of crap in here. Ooh, they got The Lie by Ken Ham, of course, and all of his books. The New Answers, Book 1, Book 2, Book 3, Book 4. All his videos, stuff for the kids. Inside the Nye-Ham Debate. That was good. Lots of stuffed animals. And here we are. The Ark Encounter. Okay. T-shirts. Lots of t-shirts. And finally, I get to run away screaming. Oh, God. It's frightening. Absolutely terrifying. Well, that's the Ark Encounter for me. That was interesting. That was also probably the biggest waste of $50 I've ever done. That was just retardation on a massive scale. I couldn't believe how stupid most of the stuff was. That was crazy. I mean, literally insanity. We'll get back to more of this now, so we got to take our bus all the way back to the parking lot. We're going to pay $10. So we're on our way back. Yep, that was stupid. That was really, really stupid. I do feel dumber at having for done this. Alrighty, thank you all. You have a good day. Alright, well, and here's where you first come in. This is where you come in. This is where they're going to have the lines, and that's where you pay.